Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. This is Jom. So in our last classes we have studied how to make a model in Tekla, how to apply various kinds of loads on our model, and how to design our members. But we haven't introduced a staircase yet. So in today's class we will introduce a staircase in our model. Also we will learn how to apply the imposed load or live load on the staircase. A staircase is a very important structural member of any building. Basically, it is used for the movement from one floor to another floor, and so its design is very much needed. So let's start.
This is our interface in Tekla, and to save the time, I have already constructed the construction level. You can see here, and you can take a screenshot of it. So once our construction level is created, we can now move on to our modeling part. So I will quickly import the DXF file. So first of all, I need the center line diagram. Dimension will be in mm, and architectural grid will be chosen by layer, and I want this center line on every particular level. So you can see I have my center line here. Okay, it's here. So I'm just defining my center line so that when I have to work on it, it comes to me handy. Now I will go to my foundation level and check the center line. Okay, so it's fine here. In base level or plinth level, I need to import the plan, I mean the shadow plan. So I will just import the shadow, change the unit to mm, and it's fine here. So here is my center line diagram with the shadow of my plan. Here we have to construct our staircase. This cross sign, this shows that there is no slab over here. Okay, so what do we do first? First of all, we make columns, right? So I will make a column here. So I need to define my column. I will make it M25. Then my column size, okay. Automatic alignment, I will turn it off so that it perfectly aligns at the center of the column. I will change my reinforcement type to Fe500, and it's done here. So now I can save it by name C1. Okay, so now I will place my columns. You can place your columns at anywhere at the intersection of your grid line or center line. So let's go to the foundation level and check. So it's perfectly aligned. Okay, in structure 3D I can see the 3D model where my column is constructed. It's fine here. Now what we need to do, we need to make our beams. So I will make beam here. So before assigning the beam, we need to define our beams. I will make it M25. Dimension is okay, and I need to change the reinforcement to Fe500, and I can also save it as B1 250 by 300. Okay, because I have assigned a sign of 250 by 300 over here. Now I will make my beam. So I can simply make my beam by dragging it. in a structure 3D, you can see my beam is present. Now, how to copy all these beams? For that, you know, we have to go to the model, then construction level, and I have beam in my plinth level. So I will change the source and make it base for all other levels, and I will click on OK. So I have beams on all my floors. Now I will go back to the construction level and make these sources unique, so that whenever I make any change in any level, then this doesn't get affected. Now the important point is, if I have to assign any beam in this section, then what I need? So now that my model is complete, I need to add a frame. So I will go to the frame and I will add a frame on this line. You can see a frame here. Now I will go to the frames and double click on it. So this will show me where my frame was inserted. Now what you need to do? I need to measure the height. However, I know that the floor to floor height is 3.2 because I have assigned it. So what is in middle of 3.2? So it's 1.6 meter. So I need a construction line here, and I will add another line at, like you have noticed it, right? That I have gone to the construction line, then chosen the parallel quick. Okay, so I'll go here, choose this one, go up, click F2 on your keyboard. Now 1.6 meter and enter. So I have my line over here. Now I'll click again, click F2, and then 1.6. So here we'll just make 1.6 meter. I'll just escape it again, choose the line and do the procedure again. So F2, 1.6. It's very hard to continue the steps. Rather, you can just press escape and choose the line again. So 1.6 meter. Here. Now we have our lines over here. Now what we need to do, we need to make beams. So I will go to the beams. I have already saved a beam of size 250 by 300. You can see the specifications. It's M25, 250 by 300 mm, and then FE 500. Okay, so it's fine. Now we will just assign the beams. We'll click here and double click here, and you can see that we have constructed our beams. So single click on this side and double click on this side. Now I will go to the 3D view, and you can see that my beams are calculated, constructed over here, like in this model. So I have my beams where my staircase will rest. Now for the staircase, we need a slab. So I will go to the slab, choose a flat slab. Here I will change the diaphragm as none, and save it as flat slab, or you can just say staircase. Okay, so this is very tricky. We need to find the center. So in this line, this is the center. Okay, so I'll choose the center here, then choose the center here, and I have the cross here over here, and double click on this one, and I have my slab over here. Simply, now we have the center point over here. So I will click here. Center of this line is the big red bubble, then this one, and then this one. So I have constructed my slab on ground floor, right? You can see that. Now if I want to copy this staircase on my other floors, then I simply need to copy this. So I will go to the edit and then choose our slabs. First hit escape button, and then holding the control button, you need to choose your slabs that you want to copy. Now click and copy, and you can see I have the cross mark over here. Okay, so I will copy it from here to my next floor, and also to my next floor. Now click on escape, so you can see that your staircase is ready. Now as we know that we have assigned and specified every details, like what grade of concrete we are using, what grade of steel we are using, and also the length and width and thickness of the slab is defined already in this model, so we don't need to apply the dead load, but we do need to apply the live load. So I will go to the imposed load, and I will choose slab load. It's 3 kN/m², which is okay. As per IS 875 part 2, live loads on the staircase should be 3 kN/m², and I will apply this load on the slab. So I'll just simply choose the slab, and the loads will be applied automatically. Okay, let's see it. So this is how you have to make the model of your staircase and impose the loads on the staircase. So that was all for today, and let me know what else you want to learn in Tekla, and I will get back to you with the same concept that you wanted to learn. Just all you need to do is to comment below in the comment section, and do like our videos. If you want to see our previous videos, I will provide the link in the description box, like how to make a model in Tekla and how to assign wind load, seismic load, dead or imposed load. Everything was already discussed in our previous classes, and I have already made a video on 3-story building designs, so you can just go and watch that video. Till then, thank you, bye bye.